I think the references in my work in some ways comes out of where I'm from, which is Singapore, which is a multicultural city in a region known as Southeast Asia, which is also a very heterogeneous and pluralistic place. So Southeast Asia, I say it's a region which is not one because it's never unified by a single religion, political system or language. So I guess another way to ask the question is what makes Southeast Asia one? So I think that was a driving force of a lot of my projects. So the Critical Dictionary of Southeast Asia is basically composed of 26 different terms, 26 different ideas to link Southeast Asia together. So the work that we see is made up of images taken from online sources, and an algorithm is editing these images live. And at the same time, this algorithm selects between 10 different versions of voiceovers to combine with the text. So for me, this work is not so much a representation of Southeast Asia, but rather it's a model. So a model in the sense of a scientific model. So you don't hope to capture Southeast Asia as a frozen representation. Rather, we create a model which is dynamic, which can transform itself, because Southeast Asia itself is a shape-shifting region and it's always transforming. Yeah, so with regards to the lenticular prints, actually, the lenticular prints are made up of 26 layers of images, each layer for each letter of the alphabet. And these are selected from the footage, which has been already pre-selected by the algorithm. And what I do is I compress these 26 layers into three different groups of images. And these three different groups of images then form the three perspectives of the lenticular print. So I guess, in a certain sense, the lenticular print is a kind of hyper-compression of the entire dictionary video. I think tigers is one of the key ways in which I reimagine the region of Southeast Asia. In many cosmologies, animist cosmologies in Southeast Asia, they actually regard the tiger as a kind of ancestral figure. They believe the tiger is a kind of container or vehicle for ancestral spirits. So this is also why I think in many parts of Southeast Asia, there are beliefs in were-tigers, people who can transform into tigers. So I would say that after tigers died, they returned as metaphors. So this is what I mean by being able to see the history of this region in a different way by following the tracks of the tigers. So I think this infinity of stories is something quite important to me as a way to resist closure, to resist reduction to one single meta-narrative. So I think it's better to let 1,001 stories bloom rather than to reduce everything to one story, which unfortunately the world at the present, there are many parties who want to reduce histories and identities to like one single source. So I guess for me, the project is much more about opening things up and letting multiple stories flower.